in Syria. This is how Syria got its name and what Syria means.
I don't know why you did that.
Anyways, go on. Okay. The Greek and Romans most likely gave Syria its name. The name probably came from the Babylonian Syria. Up until the 20th century, many Arabs referred to this area as names such as Sham, which when translated means northern region, the north, Syria, or Damascus. You may still hear Arabs call this area the area of Jordan, Syria, and Israel and Lebanon, Sham. This symbolizes Arab unity. The art of ancient and modern Syria. These are art like that they've done. This is modern. That's the guy who did that, and some self-portrait of him. It's modern. That's modern. That one's ancient. That's ancient. I think that one's ancient. And these two are, and then the modern ones down there. The language of Syria. The official language of Syria is Arabic. More than 90% of Syrians speak Arabic. 90.3% of the country is Arab. Other languages spoken there are Malula, I think, Aramaic, and Syriac. These are what people look like. That's the first lady. Those are children in Syria. A lady. That's a man in like their cultural outfit. It's a woman in a cultural outfit. That's somebody who's in like poverty. And then that's someone who's Kurdish. That's how they're outfit. The technology of Syria. Ancient Syria used technology such as water wheels. Now Syria is more equipped with higher technology such as laptops, cell phones, and high-tech navigation and more. The religion of Syria. 74% of Syria is Sunni Muslim. All the Muslims in Syria must obey the five pillars. 10% of them are Christian. 10% of the Syrians are Christian, and there's a small amount of Jewish people there. They didn't give up per se. Okay. I think you can click it one more time. Oh. Okay. Go back. Sorry. I don't know why. It just says Syria. Okay. The capital of Syria is Damascus. The head of government. Is Prime Minister Mohammed Naji. I can't pronounce his name. The Chief of State is President Bashar al-Assad.